In this lesson, we will discuss for loops. If you want to execute a set of statements a certain number of times, you should use a for loop. A for loop begins with the for statement, followed by the name of a variable whose value will change by an amount delta each time the statements in the loop are executed. Initially, this variable, which is called var here, is assigned the value of startVal. StartVal and endVal determine the range of values var must stay within for the loop to proceed. Specifying the increment delta is optional. If you omit step delta, the default step size will be +1, and delta may be positive or negative. At the start of the loop, if delta is positive, the loop will proceed if var is less than or equal to endVal. If the initial value of var is less than or equal to endVal, the statements inside the loop are executed. However, if the initial value of var is greater than endVal, VBA will skip the loop. After the statements are executed and the loop reaches the next var statement, var is incremented by delta and VBA returns to the top of the loop. If var is still less than or equal to endVal, the statements in the loop will be executed again with the updated value of var. This looping process is repeated until var is greater than endVal, at which time the loop is terminated. If delta is negative, the loop will proceed if var is greater than or equal to endVal. If the initial value of var is greater than or equal to endVal, the statements inside the loop are executed. However, if var is less than endVal, VBA will skip the loop. When the loop reaches the next var statement, var is decreased by delta and VBA returns to the top of the loop. If var is still greater than or equal to endVal, the statements in the loop will be executed again with the updated value of var. This looping process is repeated until var is less than endVal, at which time the loop is terminated. It is strongly suggested that you indent the statements inside your loops by about 3 or 4 spaces to help make your code more readable. Let's see an example of how to use a for loop. This program will calculate the sum and average of all integers 1 through 3 using a for loop. The sum and average are stored in the variables sum and avg. In this for loop, the variable I will be the counter variable. I starts at 1 and will increase its value by 1 each time the next I statement is executed. When I becomes greater than 3, the loop will terminate. Step 1 is optional here because the default increment size is +1. Inside the for loop, 2 statements are executed. The first statement is sum equals sum plus I. In order to calculate the summation, we must add the current value of I to a running total, which is stored in the variable sum. Notice that sum is set to 0 initially before the for loop begins. Whenever you use a for loop to perform a summation, you should assign 0 to the variable that will store the summation before the for loop in case that variable contains a value other than 0. The second statement creates a message box that displays the current value of the variables I and sum. After the loop terminates, the average is calculated and stored in the variable avg. The average is the sum divided by the number of integers, which is 3. Finally, a message box displays the current value of I, sum, and avg. When we run the program, four message boxes appear. The first message box states I equals 1, sum equals 1. The second message box states I equals 2, sum equals 3. The third message box states I equals 3, sum equals 6. And the fourth message box states I equals 4, sum equals 6, average equals 2. Let's explore why these values appear. When the variables I, sum, and AVG are declared, they are assigned default initial values of 0. Next, sum is assigned the value 0. In this particular example, the sum equals 0 statement is unnecessary since sum is assigned the value 0 when it is declared. However, it's good programming practice to set the summation variable to 0 before the loop begins, just in case you assigned a non-zero value to it earlier in the program. At the start of the for loop, I is assigned the value 1. Since I is less than or equal to 3, we enter the loop. Sum is assigned the current value of sum plus I, which is 0 plus 1. So the new value of sum is 1. A message box then appears that displays the value of I and sum, which are 1 and 1. We then reach the next I statement and increase I by the step size, which is 1. I now has the value of 2. Since I is less than or equal to 3, we go back to the beginning of the loop. Sum is assigned the current value of sum plus I, which is 1 plus 2. So the new value of sum is 3. A message box appears that displays the value of I and sum, which are currently 2 and 3. We reach the next I statement again and increase the value by 1. I now has the value of 3. Since I is still less than or equal to 3, we go back to the beginning of the loop. Sum is assigned the current value of sum plus I, which is 3 plus 3. The new value of sum is 6. A message box appears that displays the value of I and sum, which are 3 and 6. We arrive at the next I statement and increase the value of I by 1. I now has the value of 4. Since I is now greater than 3, we exit the loop. AVG is assigned the value of sum divided by 3, which is 6 divided by 3, or 2. A message box displays the value of I, sum, and AVG, which are 4, 6, and 2. Here's a flowchart representation of this program. The variable sum is set to 0. When the loop begins, I is set to 1. The exit condition for the loop is when I greater than 3 is true. Since I greater than 3 is false at the moment, we enter the loop and execute the two statements inside the loop. We return to the top of the loop and increase I by 1. I greater than 3 is still false, so the loop is repeated. This looping process continues until I greater than 3 is true, at which point the loop is broken. A final message box appears and the program is terminated. Notice that if we want to change our program to add all integers from 1 to 4, we would have to change the number 3 to the number 4 in two locations. If we accidentally forgot to change one of the 3's to a 4, our program would not work correctly. It could be safer and easier if we created another variable and assigned the value of 4 to that variable. When we run the program, we'll calculate the sum and average of all numbers 1 to n, and in this case, n is 4. The sum is 10, the average is 2.5. If we want to adjust the number of integers that are summed, we only have to adjust the value of n at one location in the program. Here's how you'd write a program that adds all integers between 1 and 4 using a negative step size. The variable n is assigned the value 4, and sum is set to 0, just like before. The counter variable I starts at n, which is 4. Since the step size is a negative value, the exit condition for the loop is when I is less than 1. At the moment, 4 is greater than 1, so we enter the loop. Sum is assigned the current value of sum plus I, which is 0 plus 4. A message box appears that displays the value of I and sum, which are currently 4 and 4. At the next I statement, we decrease I by 1, and now I has the value of 3. 3 is still greater than 1, so we enter the loop again. This process continues until I is 2, then 1, and then finally 0. When I has the value 0, the loop is broken, since 0 is less than 1. After the loop is terminated, the average is calculated and assigned to the variable AVG, and a message box displays the value of I, sum, and average. I is 4, sum is 4. I is 3, sum is 7. I is 2, sum is 9. I is 1, sum is 10. I is 0, sum is 10. Average is 2.5. We can terminate for loops early using the exit for statement. In this program, the for loop has the potential of undergoing 11 iterations, with the value of x changing from 0 to 1 in increments of 0.1. However, if the value of x is greater than 0.2, the exit for statement will be executed, terminating the loop prematurely. Inside loop x equals 0, inside loop x equals 0.1, inside loop x equals 0.2, and finally outside loop x equals 0.3. When x is 0.3, the exit for statement is executed and the for loop is terminated.